Right now, we're here with Kodak. They got some brand new, very cool film. I'm here with Scott DiSabato and Yvette Roman. So, Scott, tell me, we talked at Imaging USA in Tampa. You guys have introduced a brand new 400 VC, 400 NC, but now it's actually here at the show. Yvette's been shooting some stuff with it. We're going to talk to her in a bit about it. But let's talk about the film's alive. It's on the street. It's going to be shipping here really quick.
Yep. The film is currently in production. We were able to grab enough film so that we'd have sample quantities here at WPPI. So we're really excited. It's a continued evolution that we have with our Portra line. We made some pretty significant improvements to the entire line back in 2006 and 2007. Now we've been able to incorporate finer grain into our 400 speeds. And I think for either optical or digital printing, scanning, it's going to be a superior product now.
Let's talk some more technical stuff about the new film stock. I know you guys have made changes to the emulsion and the stock that actually has a finer grain pattern. What are the kind of changes you guys done to the actual film itself?
Yeah, you know, it really centers around the emulsion technology and the grain. We've got higher efficiency T grain in this film, so it's going to do a better job at collecting light. And then within the emulsion itself, we have brand new antenna dye, which we borrowed from our Vision 3 motion picture films, that actually allow more light to descend down into the emulsion. And the smaller the more light that can reach the grain, the smaller that grain can be. So we end up with finer grain.
Now, for people that don't know, tell us the difference between the VC and the NC.
Well, the VC stands for vivid color. So it's going to retain a very good skin tone, yet the other primary colors that would be in the image are going to have more saturation. The natural color film here, the NC film, again, does the skin tones extremely well, but it has more of an accurate, romantic, muted color associated with it that's a very nice choice between those two.
Now, with the latitude of this film, let's say if I want to shoot it at 200, am I still safe? Let's say I use NC and I want to shoot it at 200, am I going to get even a less saturated, even more creamy skin tone? How's that sort of work out with the Portra line?
Well, you know, the exposure of these color neg films are very elastic. So I would still recommend you shoot it at the rated 400. But if you happen to over or underexpose it by 2-3 stops, you're still going to get a very good usable image. So we've got 3 stops of overexposure latitude and 2 stops of underexposure latitude.
Wow, pretty broad range.
Oh, yeah. T-Grain's a phenomenal product, and we have it incorporated into almost all of our professional products at this point, certainly anything that's been developed in the past 10 years or so.
Yeah, it's great to see you guys are making new stock and just keep updating all your stuff. So, Scott, where do people find out more information about the new line of Portra film and all the stuff you guys are up to on the pro line of Kodak?
Well, everything's on the website, as you know. So www.kodak.com/go/Portra is where you can find more information about the Portra films.
Scott, thank you so much.
All right, thanks.
So, you bet. We're talking to Scott. You know, he's got the film out now. You actually prototyped, did some black hand development of the film. Tell me about your thoughts on the new 400 VC NC and all the stuff that you're up to.
Well, I tested Portra NC, and it was a fabulous film. It has really fine grain and amazing skin tones, and it's just beautiful. I can't say enough about it.
Now, the stuff that you're doing with the portrait and the wedding work, do you shoot the 400 to 400? Do you push it? Do you pull it? How do you like to work with the film?
You know, I shoot mostly Portra NC for all the color, and I don't really push or pull it that much. It doesn't need much, and it has this incredible latitude. You can be off a little bit, and it still is beautiful, which is important for a wedding because, you know, when you're shooting 60 rolls of film and 2,000 images, sometimes you can make a mistake metering, but it has a huge latitude. It can really hold up.
Wow. So let's talk about your, as a photographer, your workflow. When you go out to shoot a wedding, what are you shooting with? What kind of gear? What cameras? What do you like to use?
I shoot Canon. They're 1Ns. And I shoot Hasselblad. And that's pretty much it. You know, I'm very reliant on those two companies and Kodak.
So. Yeah, what's your favorite piece of glass when you're out shooting a wedding?
My lenses, you mean?
Yeah.
I love the 24-70 Canon, and also it's great for weddings. They have a 16 to 24 zoom, and it's rectilinear, so it doesn't have any, nothing gets bowed. So it's perfect for parties. Nobody's nose looks wide or anything.
Yeah, Yvette, so you shot 30, 40, 50 rolls of film at an event. What's your workflow when you're done? Do you send it out, scan your own stuff? What's your workflow to actually build the stuff so you can build your beautiful albums and the prints and the stuff you're doing after you've acquired it via film?
Exactly. Well, it goes to the lab, and then they scan it, and we work on the scans back at the studio, and they have the proofs are made from the edited scans. And then we go make prints from the digital or from the negatives, depending on the client and what they want. So we can do fiber prints and or prints from the scans, either way.
How much has it actually saved you as a photographer with shooting film compared to shooting the people that shoot all digital? Because, you know, a lot of people shoot digital, 4,000 or 5,000 images at a wedding, and then you have to bring all the stuff in Photoshop and fix it all.
Right.
Does it actually save you time by shooting film?
Oh, absolutely. And nothing looks like film. You know, and they're two completely different tools. They're both amazing tools, but they're not the same. And I think that's a common mistake photographers make, is saying the digital looks like film, because it doesn't.
And no matter how many tweaks you can do in Photoshop and plugins, it's not the same.
No, I don't think so. But also, there's very little color correction that you need with film. You know, it's all there. Everything's there. It wants to pick up the whites and the highlights, detail and the highlight and the detail and the blacks. And it just it has such a wide tonal range. So
Yvette, do you have a website people can go look at your images? You have a blog, anything going on? Where can people find out about you?
I do. I have a website. It's yrphoto.com, and I don't know. That's it.
That's cool stuff. You know, beautiful images in the booth. Your photo album's great work. It's really nice.
Thank you so much.
There you go. Brand new cool stuff from Kodak, and you can check it out at www.kodak.com.